Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Dear students, I hope that all of you are fine, feeling well, and studying at home, giving a proper time to your studies. You know that this chapter is basically technical in nature. We have to learn the pros and cons of data communication. So yesterday we have gone through transmission modes, different types of transmission modes. Basically, there are two types. So before going towards the next lesson, I would like to know from you people that basically what was the topic and what we have learned from it. Can anyone give a quick review of it? What do you understand by transmission mode? How many types are there? Kindly. Yes, Aryan Ali.
Sir, asynchronous transmission, the transmission mode in which the time interval between each character is not the same, is known as asynchronous transmission.
Okay.
Synchronous transmission, the transmission mode in which the time interval between the characters is always the same, is known as synchronous transmission.
Okay, fine. So what we are doing, we are saying that we need to have a quick review of the last work. What is simply transmission mode? If you don't say what are the different types, what is transmission mode? Who is going to define? All the students should check their mics that these are attached properly. Kindly check the mics. Whenever I ask, you have to unmute yourself. Yes, please. Yes, anyone from the girls? How would you define the term transmission mode? How you are going to define this term transmission mode? This term that I have mentioned over here. What do you understand by this? We have already discussed about it yesterday. Yes, please, in your own words. Yes. Abdul Hadi, can you? Abdul Hadi. Malik Masab, can you explain?
Yes, something? Sir.
Yes.
Sir, the way in which...
How you are going to write?
Sir, the way in which data is transmitted from one device to another is known as transmission mode.
The form of the data, the form in which shape, in which form, in which structure the data is going to be transmitted from one device to another device. And definitely, when the data is being passed, it is going to follow some specific transmission mode. So there are two types, as Aryan has explained over here, asynchronous and synchronous. We had discussed about some characteristics. Can anyone explain those characteristics? You know, some characteristics were there that we discussed yesterday. What are the characteristics? Let's suppose I'm talking about right now asynchronous. So what are different characteristics of asynchronous transmission? Who is going to define this? What is there in asynchronous transmission? Voluntarily just unmute yourself and give the reply. Abdul Muiz, asynchronous transmission. Yes.
Yes.
Fatma Zahra, can you? How data transmits in asynchronous transmission? How data transmits? Do you remember that thing?
Sir, can I?
Yes, Aryan Ali.
In asynchronous transmission, the information should be transmitted character by character.
Character by character. Okay. And what would be there? Any other specific characteristics? Any other specific characteristic? Do you remember some specific characteristics were there when the data is being transmitted? What kind of bits were there? There were two important bits, remember?
Start bit and stop bit.
Yeah, parity bits. There are two parity bits, start bit and the stop bit, which is going to identify the initialization of a new character and the ending of that particular character. Any other thing? What is there? So what do we say? that the data will be transmitted number one character by character? Yes, of course, you are right. Then there is basically start bit and stop bit. Start bit and stop bits will be there, which are called parity bits. Then interval is there or not? Who is going to explain the interval? Interval between the characters. When one character is over, there is interval. When another character is over, then there is interval. Interval is basically the gap. Interval is basically the gap between the characters. Yes, Fatma Zahra, can you define this? What are these characteristics of asynchronous transmission? Please. Yes. Now come towards the synchronous transmission. What are the characteristics of synchronous transmission? Who will define? Synchronous. Asynchronous is fast or slow? Asynchronous is fast or slow?
Slow.
Yes, please.
Asynchronous is slow, sir.
Asynchronous is slow. Now come towards the synchronous transmission. Come towards the synchronous transmission. What do you understand by synchronous transmission? The data is sent in the form of characters. Just quickly review this, then I have to move towards the next topic. Just give me a review, and I have told you that I need the review from the students. I am not going to repeat the last thing that what I was teaching. You have to tell me, you have to explain me, you must have the books in front of you, you must have the notes given in the Google Classroom in front of you. You should open, you can open that thing. Yes, please.
Sir, there are no spaces between characters being sent.
Okay, good. There is no space between the characters. How data is sent? In which format data is going to be sent? In which format? What is the format of the data? Character by character? What is the format of the data?
Sir, characters.
No. It is frames, blocks, or chunks. You know, we said that the data is going to be transmitted in the form of packets. And for packets, I told you that these are basically the blocks or chunks or frames. Means collection of bytes. Collection of bytes will send together. Data will be sent in the form of blocks or chunks. So, of course, the transmission will be fast. The transmission will be fast or slow? Transmission is not corrected by character. That's why the transmission will be fast. And similarly, what we said that what is there? There is start bit or stop bit available in the synchronous transmission? No. So, what is available? One specific thing was there which was available. Kindly.
Sir, clock, I remember.
Clock pulse. Not clock something.
Clock pulse.
Clock pulse, which manages the synchronized transmission from one device to another device. There is clock pulse. So whenever we are writing the differences, we are going to write that in asynchronous transmission, there is basically data transmission, which is bit by bit. So what is the data transmission over here? Frames, blocks, chunks. Similarly, when we are differentiating, the interval is available in asynchronous, but clock pulse is available in synchronous. So in this way, you can write discrete 4-5 differences between the two. This point is clear or not? Clear or not?
Yes, sir.
Will you be able to write the differences? If the question comes for 3 or 4 marks, that write differences. You have to write differences. And I had shared with you one table of differences. Just like clock pulse, about the clock pulse, about transmission speed, form of the data. That data is in the form of blocks, you know, in synchronous transmission, but it is in the form of characters or bytes in asynchronous transmission. Similarly, we said that time interval is there in asynchronous, but no specific interval is there. There is a clock pulse to manage the synchronized transmission in synchronous transmission. So these are basically the differences. Similarly, you can differentiate on the basis of the cost as well. cost, which one is expensive?
Synchronous.
Synchronous is definitely expensive. Okay. Now, come towards the topic for today. Today, we are going to see types of transmission media. How do you define transmission media? I suppose that everyone should have the books opened in front of him. The books should be opened in front of you. You are not supposed to Google. If you are going to Google it, then you should make a clear concept and then you should reply. Does not mean that you open it from the Google and you start reading and you start telling me that this is the thing. This is not the right way. You have to understand this thing. Okay. So let me open the book. We were on chapter number 4. The topics that we have already covered are asynchronous and asynchronous transmission. Now, after synchronous and asynchronous transmission, we are going to have transmission media. What is meant by media? Who will define the media? You would have listened this term in the general life as well, media. Independence of media, liberty of media, use of media. So what do you understand? How will you define if it comes for 3 marks? What you are going to write? Any one of you, not necessary that your answer is correct. Not necessary. Any one of you. Yes, please.
Transmission media, the means by which data travels from source to destination. In other words, it is the pathway for transmitting data.
Good. But you always, you are not supposed to read. Just read it and reply it in your own words. It is going to make basically your memory that what you are going to write. So basically, the media is the way, means, resource of communication for data. Communication for data from source to destination. From source to destination. We have got different types of media. You know, we say that we are watching television. Television is a media. Internet is a media. Why we say? Because the data is coming towards us. Data is coming towards us through that media. So in computing, when one device is sending data to another device, there are some types. Now this point is clear. Now we are talking about the digital devices, computers. Over here, what we are saying? We are saying that communication, basically this is communication between devices. Between devices. When two devices are talking to each other, when two devices are communicating with each other, so what kind of media is available? So how many types are there? We categorize in two types. Major two types are there in which we categorize them. What are the two types? Yes, Iman Abid. Can you tell about it? What are the two types, major types? Yes, please.
Guided media and unguided media.
Your voice is not clear. You need to increase the voice.
Guided media.
Guided media. Yes, guided media. Guided media and unguided media. Guided media is also called bounded media. Guided media is also called wired media. So we have got number one, as she has said, guided media and unguided media. When we say unguided, it means wireless. When we say guided, it means wires. Guided is also called bounded media. You will also listen this term. And it is also called wired media. Unguided is also called unbounded media. And it is also called wireless media. So what are these two types of media? I have displayed one chart over here for you. You can see over here. In this chart, you can see that basically there are two types, guided and unguided. There are further categories available in guided media, and there are further categories available in unguided media. Unguided means wireless, radio waves, microwaves, different types of waves available. So if we talk about the guided media, how many categories are there? Basically, there are 3 major categories. We are talking about the digital devices that when data is being transmitted, there are 3 categories of the wires through which the data is going to be transferred. What are these 3 categories? Can anyone tell me about it? What are these three categories? Yes, please. Hiba Amin, Sayyid Muhammad Hussain. You should also unmute yourself. Hiba Amin, you should also unmute yourself. Yes, Iman, if you want to say something, your voice is not clear, but. Yes, Sayyid Muhammad Hussain. Hussain, will you unmute yourself? You unmute yourself.
Yes, sir.
Can you tell me the three types of the guided media? Have you ever seen any one of them? The picture is already displayed in front of you. I'm talking about. Have you
pair.
Teams ever?
These things. Fiber optical, sir, I have seen.
You have seen fiber optic. You have seen fiber optic because now the nowadays the fiber optic is available for the internet connection and one end of the wire when it comes inside your house to be attached with your device, so you become able to see this. What kind of wire it is? Have you seen this?
A LAN cable.
Yes, please. Anyone, any student. Coaxial cable and twisted pair cable. Have you seen the twisted pair cable and coaxial cable? Can anyone tell me about
it? I have seen coaxial cable.
Yes, Aryan. Where you have seen the coaxial cable?
Sir, our old internet, it is coaxial cable. Now we have changed. Before it was coaxial cable.
Which one? Where it is used? Where you have seen?
I have seen using for this antennas, dish antennas and others also.
Dish antennas, good. Means basically this is the TV cable that you have seen in your houses. You know, I'm going to share the pictures afterwards. TV cable, which has got a single copper wire in it. And twisted pair cable. Is there any student who has seen the twisted pair cable? Yes, Fatma Zahra, you can unmute yourself directly. Just unmute yourself and you can reply for this.
Sir, I think they're used in extensions when more than one wire needs to be connected, I think.
Where you have seen the twisted pair cable? Have you ever seen
this? Yes, sir.
Where?
Sir, in extensions, when we need to connect something, there it is used. It is like a pipe.
Okay, fine.
And then multiple wires are fixed
fine,
inside.
Fine, good. When you connect with your Wi-Fi, you would have seen in your houses as well. When you connect a desktop PC with your Wi-Fi using wire, that is basically a twisted pair cable. It is similar to the telephone, traditional telephone cable. Anyway, so why I was asking, because we are familiar with all these three in your computer lab, in your school, colleges, in universities. You would have seen that in your computer lab, the computers, the desktop computers are attached with a switch. So over there as well, even we have got a twisted pair cable. Twisted pair cables have got four copper wires in it, which are available in different colors. I am going to share with you. So how you are going to define the guided media? The question arises over here, and what kind of feature it has got? What are different features available with the wired media? So number one, it is basically the wired media. It is also referred as wired media, or also called bounded media. Okay, signals being transmitted are directed and confined in the narrow pathway. There is a narrow pathway in which the signal is going to be transmitted. Of course, you need to have current or some other technology, light, just like light is there in fiber optic. Otherwise, digital current will be there, which will be passing through the physical links. So this is basically the wired media. How would you define it? It is defined as the wired or bounded media. Signals are transmitted directly and confined inside the narrow pathway, physical pathway. What are the characteristics? It will have high speed. Why? Because the devices are attached directly. There is no one who is going to disturb the wire, because the wires are normally underground or inside the channel or inside the walls. So there isn't any issue regarding the security. Security will also be high, And of course, it is used for short distances. You cannot spread the wires on the long distances. You are not supposed to connect two cities or two countries using wires. Definitely, it is not possible. Why? Because it will cost a lot, and definitely it is not a proper approach. You have to move towards the wireless technology in this case. So high speed will be there, it will be secured, it will be used for the short distances. So if a question comes that define guided media, write its two characteristics, write its three features. So you are going to write that its speed will be high, it will be secured enough, it will be used for the short distances. This point is clear or not? So you will be able to write or not? Features or characteristics? Yes, please. Students give response. Okay. So in wired medium, how many types are there? We have seen the definition. What are the wired mediums? What is meant by a wired media? What is meant by guided media? Where it is used? Now, in short questions, you may be asked about it, that where it is used, where the wired medium will be used. Examples can also be asked, and where it is used. This can also be asked, that where you are going to use. In televisions, you connect the television with the wire or not? Normally you connect. LAN in the office, local area network in the office. Additional telephones are there. So you, in traditional telephones, you are going to use these twisted pair cable. In computer lab, twisted pair cables are there. Inside the home, when you are getting fiber optic connection, so there would be wire. So these are the areas where it is being used. Areas of services, where they are providing their services, where they are serving the mankind. These are the areas that you can write in your paper. This point is clear or not? Students, just give me the feedback by thumbs up sign that this point is clear. Clear or not? Just tell me about it quickly. Good. I'm happy to see that most of the students have got the point, and I hope that you will be able to reproduce it. You will be able to write in your paper. You have no confusion about it. And I'm going to provide you this data, inshallah, in your Google Classroom. Okay. Now come towards the next point. What kind of questions can be asked? Define media, give two examples. What are two major types of media? Where wired medias are used? Such kind of questions can be asked. Now come towards the types of the wired media. As we have seen in this diagram, that wired media, guided media has got three major categories: twisted pair, coaxial, and fiber optic cable. So if you will go towards the twisted pair cable, so now what kind of cable it is? Yes, Aisha, you can unmute yourself and you can ask me if you've got any question. Thumbs up sign is there to give me response when you have no question but you are satisfied. And hands up sign is there. This is basically to show that you want to ask something. Okay. Now, twisted pair cables. What is meant by twist? Twist, you know, when you are moving around two things, just like two wires are there. So when you are moving around two wires, this is called twist. So there are, you know, twists in the wires. There are basically eight copper wires are there, and there are pairs of two copper wires, means there will be four pair means eight copper wires. And each copper wire has got some different color insulation. Means the outer cover. You can see over here, can you see this thing? Just notice this thing. See this thing? Yeah. That this is one pair, this is basically a pair. You can see over here. These are the four pairs available. This is one pair, this is one pair, this is one pair, this is one pair. So how many pairs are there? Four pairs are there. Okay. How many wires are there? Eight wires are there. Four pairs. Now this is orange, white. This is blue, white. This is green, white. And this is brown white. Orange white, on white there are orange dots, you know, on white, so that we can understand that which white will come with the orange, which wire will come with the, which white wire will come with the blue. So there will be dots on the white wire, so that blue dots wire will be attached with this blue color wire. In this way we have got these four copper wires. So we arrange them and we make a connector, and there is an insulation sheet as well. You can see over here that an external jacket, outside jacket is there. Outside jacket is there to save it, to save the wire. Okay. And sometimes there is an other jacket even on it. On it there is an other jacket, outside jacket. So that is basically an outer jacket to make the wire more secure, and it should have more strength against the external and outside, you know, outside noise or heat and outside effects, whatever are there. So this type of wire, normally this type looks like a single wire, but inside there are eight copper wires, and each copper wire is insulated with different color sheets, with different color plastics material, rubber material. Generally several such wires are bundled together in a protective sheet. They are the most widely used transmission media, you know, in short distance, in local area network. Whenever we are making the local area network, we are always going to use the twisted pair cable. This is basically the twisted pair cable. The diagram is showing you. If you go to the internet, if you will Google it, you will have more diagrams and videos available for the twisted pair cable. Just like if I say that, I have shown you the clear images. Now you can see that this kind of cable is there, which is basically called the twisted pair cable. Inside wires are there, insulation is there. In those insulation, copper wires are there. Outer jackets are there. Sometimes more outer jackets are there, so that the wire should be protected. That is called shielded twisted pair. You can see in this diagram, a number of images would be available from simplest to complex images. But normally this would be the structure. This is the structure. This is the structure that I am showing you right now. It is for shielded, foil shielded cable. Means outer jacket, external jacket, another separate jacket is given so that there should not be any problem in the transmission. There should not be any issue in the transmission regarding outside effects. This problem is now clear. This thing is clear. I hope that twisted pair cable is clear. Now come towards the two types of the twisted pair cable. As I have discussed, as I have already shown you, that basically twisted pair cable is unshielded or shielded. Shielded will not have an external hard sheet on it. It will have only one cover. This just like this plastic cover. But shielded will have an external cover as well. External cover that is going to make it more secure. This is the only difference between the shielded and the unshielded. So first we discuss about unshielded. So in unshielded, inside the structure is same in both the cases. There would be eight wires. There isn't any change. Except the only thing which is the external foil cover, which is there to make the foil, to make the wire more protected. Now the type of the cable has the ability to block interference and does not depend on a physical shield for this purpose. Means twisted pair cable will also be having good strength, but it does not have an external cover which has more immunity against the external interference. So there isn't extra immunity against the external. When we say external interference, what does it mean? It means that noise, heat, environmental effects, if some machine is there in the outside, if some electrical lines are going with the data lines, so there would be some interference of that current that is going through, that is passing through it. So such kind of things are going to disturb the data communication. So in that situation, when we are going to have outside installation, so we prefer shielded twisted pair. So what are the advantages? Least expensive, easy to install. Now these are the advantages in terms of usage. Number one, least expensive. If we compare it with the coaxial cable, or if we compare it with the fiber optic. Fiber optic is too costly. So this is least expensive, number one. Number two, easy to install. Even you can make the connector and you can attach one computer in your home to another computer. Even without internet, you can attach it with a wire. You can transmit the data. So making connectors, installing, using, all these things are quite easy. If we compare it with the fiber optic installation is too difficult. High speed accuracy is there. Accuracy, high speed is there. High speed is available. Capacity is high because we have got a good bandwidth of data transmission. Good bandwidth of data transmission would be there, which is not available normally wirelessly. Susceptible to external interference. It has got the immunity to hold the external interference, and it tries to protect the data transmission without any outside interference. Lower capacity and performance in comparison of STP. STP is shielded. Shielded, if you will compare it with the shielded is better. Definitely, it's shielded cost is better. Shielded twisted pair cable is better than the unshielded twisted pair cable. This point is clear. Shielded twisted pair cable is why it is better, because it has got an external protection. Data transmission will be quite smooth. There won't be such kind of issues. Short distance transmission is done only. You cannot use it for the long distances. If you will try to use it for the long distance, there will be attenuation. What is meant by the term attenuation? What do you understand by the term attenuation? Weakness in the signal. Attenuation means weakness in the signal. So there are some terminologies used over here. I would like to explain you. I think all these things are clear. Interference. What is meant by interference? Who is going to explain this point? Interference. Yes, please. Interference. Yes, please unmute yourself. Interference outside. Problems from the outside which are going to damage the data or signal quality. That is called interference. Interference is basically the problems from the outside, external interference. That may be because of the noise, number one. That may be because of the sunlight. That may be because of the, you know, heat, weather conditions, rain. If rain is there, environment, other environmental factors can be there. Okay. So these all are the things which are going to interfere in the data transmission. That is why it is called interference. This point is clear, students, or not? Please give me the thumbs up sign so that I can understand that this point is clear. Kindly. Because these are important terminologies, and if you are not well aware of it and I am using these terminologies, so how you are going to understand these points? Come towards the next thing. There is a, as we have mentioned, that there is a physical shield on it. This is the shield. But outer jacket is not there. Outer jacket is there in the shielded twisted pair cable. The shielded twisted pair cable uses outer jacket. But this twisted pair cable, which is unshielded, there is no outer jacket. Only outer cover is there, which is basically the physical shield. So this is also going to protect. But its protection is not that much high as we have got in shielded. This point is clear. Where it is used? For telephone lines and for local area networks. We are going to use it in the local area network. Inside the computer lab, you know, you would have seen in the computer lab. All wires which are there in your computer lab, these are twisted pair cable. Okay. So if you talk about the cost, least expensive, easy to install, these points are, I think these two points are quite clear. Now, high speed capacity, this point is clear or not? Means its bandwidth is high, data transmission is with a good speed, remarkable speed. Susceptible to external interference, What does it mean? Now this point I think now clear. It has the power to protect the wires inside where the signal is going on from the outside interference. It has the capacity, although that capacity is comparatively low if we compare it with the STP, shielded twisted pair, but it has the capacity. Okay. Then the next important thing is that it has less capacity, lower performance if we compare it with the shielded twisted pair cable. And it is used only for short distances. Otherwise, there will be attenuation if you will use it for long distances. Attenuation means weakness of the signal. Signal will be weak. You will have to use amplifier. You will have to use repeater, boosters in order to regenerate the signal on the same strength. Are you getting this point or not? So, if you are using for more than 100 meters, 200 meters, so what will happen? That the signal will be weak and the data will not be transmitted in a proper way. And you know that, what were the characteristics for good communication? Who will tell me? Who has got the good memory? Three characteristics we had seen for the good communication.
Delivery, accuracy, timeliness.
Good, Aryan. Delivery means the data should reach on the desired destination. Number two, timeliness, the data should reach within the due time. And number three, accuracy, the data should not be altered, there should not be any loss, there should not be any change. So if we will use this kind of wire for long distances, so there won't be any good communication. Why? Because it supports you for short distances. I hope this point is clear now. These all points are clear. Now we have got, I think, 1 minute left. If you have got any question, please, students, ask me. Inshallah, in the next class, we are going to start about the shielded twisted pair cable as well. Now you will see that we have got this type of connectors. You know, this connector you would have seen that you normally attach with your Wi-Fi device if you are going to connect any other computer or desktop PC directly using wire. Okay. So these two video links are there. Inshallah, I am going to share with you in your Google Classroom. I will also play these videos in the next class. We will see that.
Ethernet cables, no?
This is about the twisted pair cable.
Okay.
So inshallah, in the next class, I am going to share these videos as well. All the data will also be uploaded, inshallah, in your Google Classroom so that you can see. So we'll discuss about the RJ45 connector, this connector which is used with the twisted pair cable. I will have a quick revision from you people, inshallah, in the next class, and students have to participate. Those who did not participate, they need to participate. Fine, students, all these points are clear. I hope. Okay. Thank you so much, all of you. Thank you so much.